أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وطبيب نفوسنا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا سيما بقية الله روحي وأرواح العالمين لمقدمه الفداء يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lihada wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. The last Tuesday evening before we commence the holy months of Ramadan, inshallah you are getting ready in preparation for the spirituality and to gain as much as the spirituality of the holy months of Ramadan. By the grace of God, I'm here tonight with the assistance of Sister Rebekah with the sign language to deliver another message, inshallah, in terms of our nearness and to seek nearness to the Almighty God for our perfection and promotion. Just to quickly recap what we've been talking about, we started some clarification a couple of weeks ago about the relation between trust in God and using the means provided to us, like for example hygienic rules, personal hygiene and things like that. And we say that there is no contradiction between them, they are all along the same concept. Then last week we spoke about resorting to the Almighty God through legitimate means He has provided us, a concept that in the Islamic terminology we refer to it as a Tawassul, as the means of nearness to God. You recall that last week I mentioned that Tawassul is one side of a coin of nearness to God. In other words, nearness to God is a coin that when you look at the side that is facing me, for example, who is resorting to God through the legitimate means, we refer to, we call that side of the coin Tawassul, or resort to God, or seeking the means provided by God. The other side of the coin that is facing the intercessor, the one who is going to intercede, intermediate or mediate between me and God, is called Shafa'at. So the topic for tonight is about Shafa'at or intercession, mediator, the one who mediates between me and God. Let me first explain to you the concept of intercession as definitely one of the Islamic principles and concepts out of religious context, and then we'll bring it to our discussion. You recall I gave an example last week about, or a couple of weeks ago, about someone who was caught in a flood and he just went to the rough top roof of his house. Helicopter came, passed by, dropped the rope, and they asked him to grab the rope and we'll pull you out. All right, that's a very good example to mention. The one who is caught in the flood has made a mess and didn't leave the house at the right time. Now he is in the top of the roof of his house. This person, what he is doing or is expected to do to resort for help, this action out of religious context is called Tawassul, seeking a means provided to him by the helicopter. The helicopter, all those rescuers who are dropping the rope and are trying to pull him out, those people are intercessors, and the action from their end is called intercession. Now, so intercession, that in the Islamic terminology is called shafa'a, is coming from the root of shafa'a. Shafa'a literally means matching, pairing. When two things pair and match each other, the guy who is caught in a flood, he is supposed to raise his hand, and the one in the helicopter, they're supposed to send, for example, the rope down. These two need to match so that the salvation occurs. The person will be rescued. All right. Another example, again, because I want you to have a good grasp of the concept before we delve into the Islamic discussions of it. Imagine, again, I don't own a house and I wish to have a house. I go to the bank, speak with my banker, or better example, even a benevolent person who wants to do a good thing for the sake of God. He wants to help me own a house. I go to him and I say that, look, brother, I want to buy a house, and can you help me? Usually he's going to turn around and say that, how much do you have? And what's the repayment process? How can you repay? All right. If I say that, look, I don't have a penny, I'm expecting you to just pay for my house, and I don't have, I cannot afford to repay you. He said, well, that's a wishful thought. I think you better remain a tenant. What happens, the normal fashion is this, that I need to put my utmost efforts, come up with some fund and say that, look, I've got 10%, 20%, 30%, more or less, certain amount of the house I have it now with me. If you can, please help me with the rest. And this is the payment arrangement. That's how I'm going to repay. This is going to work most likely. This is in the, literally it's called shafa'a. So shafa'a is like the guy, that benevolent person says, okay, any dollar you put, I'm going to match it, dollar for dollar. This is the match, and then the action will take place. Now we bring this to the Islamic terminologies. In the Islamic terminologies, one of the principles, one of the laws that the gracious God, the merciful God has introduced to us to help us. Remember the terms I'm using, gracious God, because God is gracious. Intercession is a grace from the Almighty God. God is just, and above justice, not beneath justice, is His grace. God could say that, look, if you make a mistake, if you sin, if you have gone wrong way all your life, tough luck. Why should I accept your repentance? Why should I accept you back? No. The gracious God says that I have introduced a law in this universe that for those who made a mess in their life sometimes, went astray in their life, they sinned, they committed offenses, all right? But now they regret it. They want to rectify the past, no matter how far they have gone, no matter how long they have been in that wrongdoing. But now the person regrets. He or she wants to change, make a change. Is it possible? The Almighty God says, yes. I have introduced a law in this world that if you meet the criteria for it, you are going to be rescued, no matter how far you had gone in the past of your life. Past is past. This is the concept of intercession and shafa'ah. Unfortunately, this concept, similar to trusting God, similar to tawassul, often is misunderstood, often is distorted, and people, they think that this is like pulling the strings. This is like saying that money talks. This is like vetoing God's rule. God wanted to punish me, and all of a sudden a savior comes in with the name of Jesus Christ, who is crucified on the cross, or with the name of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, who was brutally massacred in Karbala. Miraculously, out of God's will, they just come and they rescue me. Nothing farther from the truth. There's no such thing that someone was ransomed so that I'll be rescued no matter what. That's when you see in the Quran, the verses, the ayat of the Quran that are denoting and rejecting shafa'at or intercession, they are talking about this distorted concept of shafa'at. When, for example, the Almighty God says, and I quote, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا لَا تَجْزِي نَفْسٌ عَنْ نَفْسٍ شَيْئًا وَلَا يُقْبَلُ مِنْهَا شَفَاعَةً. Guard yourself. Be prepared for a great judgment day who is going to be ahead of you. A day that no one will avail anyone else. A day that no ransom will be taken for anyone else. And no intercession will be accepted. Where here Quran says no intercession will be accepted, Quran is talking about misconception of intercession. Quran is talking about this, it wants to clarify. Don't think like in this dunya, you know, some rich people, they think that money talks. Anything with money, I can fix it. Don't worry about it. In this world, because I've got connections, I can always pull the strings and get things fixed. They think that in the hereafter is like this as well. Life after death is the life of reality. Quran wants to say that on the great day of judgment, on the judgment day, there is no such so-called intercessions. So وَلَا تُقْبَلُ شَفَاعَةٌ, it means that don't misunderstand the shafa'ah. This shafa'ah that is in your mind, sorry, doesn't exist.
in the hereafter. Doesn't exist in relation between you and God, even in this world. That's why, for example, similarly, ayat that the Almighty God is denoting and denying the intercession of idols. What are these pieces of woods and timbers to intercede? Quran says, لَيْسَ لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونَهِ وَلِيٌّ وَلَا شَفِيعٌ. Besides Allah, there is no guardian, there is no intercessor. So the actual, original, essential intercessor is the Almighty God. Then the Almighty God, as we learned tonight, has delegated certain people who meet certain criteria. He has given them authority to intercede. Not any time they can, how they can intercede. Idols, what are the idols that you're expecting them to intercede? Because the infidels of Quraysh, they assume that, oh, all right, you see why I'm prostrating before these pieces of, I don't know, timber and stones and things like that? Because I want them to intercede between me and God. God says, how foolish are you? What are these to intercede? Even Quran says, وَكَمْ مِنْ مَلَكٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ لَا تُغْنِي شَفَاعَتُهُمْ لا تغني شفاعتهم شيئا إلا من بعد أن يأذن لهم من بعد أن يأذن الله لمن يشاء ويرضى. Quran says even angels, yes, angels are infallible in all senses of it. Angels are infallible. If they intercede, their intercession will be accepted. But even angels are not allowed to intercede, and they will not intercede unless for those, except for those that the Almighty God gives permission. Who are they? لمن يشاء ويرضى. For those that the Almighty God wills and is pleased with them. I will tell you tonight, who are those that God is pleased with them to be intercede? Okay? So prophets, even angels, successors of the prophets, believers, all those who have the authority to intercede, they will intercede under conditions, my friend. Always conditions apply. That's why the true, the correct concept of intercession is what the, I just quote one famous part of famous ayah that you all inshallah know, Ayatul Kursi. مَنْ ذَلَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Who is there? Meaning that there's no one who would intercede with Allah unless by the leave, unless by the permission of God. A prime example in the Quran about this concept of intercession on the one side, and on the other side of it, tawassul, can be found in the story of Prophet Yusuf, Joseph. You know, long story short, that the brothers of Yusuf, the children, the sons of Jacob, they made such a horrible mistake and sin, attempting to kill their younger brother. All right, they threw him to the well, and all the story. And for years they tried to cover it up. For years they lied to their father. That was a very big sin. However, at the end, they regretted. And they turn around to their father as a prophet and say, قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا إِسْتَغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا خَاطِئِينَ. Dad, seek God's forgiveness for us. We admit no justification. We admit that we were wrongdoers. This is tawassul, resorting to God through legitimate means provided by God. So from their act, from their side, that is called tawassul. Now, shafa'at is in the next ayah. Prophet Jacob, Yaqub, did not say that, go and do it yourself. Why should I do that? No. He interceded them by the leave of God. He says, قَالَ سَوْفَ أَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ رَبِّي إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. He said, I will. The narration say that he postponed it to the next morning. He said, I will seek God's forgiveness for you, because it is God, only He, who is oft forgiving, most merciful. So the oft forgiving, most merciful God has appointed and had appointed at that time Jacob, Prophet Yaqub, as an intercessor, legitimate intercessor. No matter who you are, no matter how far you are, even if you attempted to kill a prophet, yet you now make a U-turn. Now you regret it. Always there is a chance for you to be interceded. So the main criterion for those who want to receive the intercession, as I will tell you, is to regret, as the brothers of Yusuf regretted it. And then by the grace of God, intercession comes. Who are those who are going to intercede? First of all, the first criterion mentioned in the Quran is that they must be definitely monotheist. They should not make any partners with God in worshiping. They should be among those who are muwahideen and believe only in one unique God. That's why Quran says, وَلَا يَمْلِكُ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ الشَّفَاعَةِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَهِدَ بِالْحَقِّ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. Nobody will own the intercession except those that they give testimony and the correct testimony. And they know who they intercede for because they have been briefed. It's just the minister has appointed a delegate and the delegate is briefed about their job description. They know who to grant, for example, visa, who to refuse, because they have guidelines. The Almighty God says that only those who are authorized. Who are those who are authorized? Shahida bilhaq. Shahida Allah annahu la ilaha illa hu wal malaikatu wa ulul ilmi qa'iman bil qist. Those who testify there is no God but Allah, one God, one unique God. So the first criteria, they must be among the believers. These believers have no power of intercession and shafa'ah. Second, Quran also says that they must also fulfill or have fulfilled the covenant. لا يملكون الشفاعة إلا من اتخذ عند الرحمن عهدا. None will own the intercession unless those who took seriously the covenant. Narration say that that covenant is the covenant of the walayat of Amirul Mu'mineen, Ahlul Bayt, the love of Ahlul Bayt, alayhi salam. For such, or from the side of the intercessors, those who adhere to that, the Imams of Ahlul Bayt, alayhi salam. And such people remember that they are not going to intercede unless for the one that the Almighty God, the real, the actual, the essential intercessor, has given permission. وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنْ اِرْتَضَى. Except for those that the Almighty God is pleased with them. Who are those that God is pleased with them to be the recipient of the intercession? Again, criteria are mentioned. I will mention the main parts. The first, as I mentioned in the story of Prophet Yusuf and his brothers, is that that person who wants to receive the intercession, whether in this world or the next, they should be in this world, they should have repented. If somebody dies without repentance, tough luck, too late for it. That's why the Holy Prophet says, La shafa'ata anjah min at-tawbah. Your actual first and foremost intercessor is your repentance, your feeling of remorse and regret. Once you have that feeling, you have now the ground for the shafa'ah. So what is it, the hadith that the Prophet says, shafa'ati li ahlil kaba'ir min ummati. Only those who have committed mortal sins, they receive my intercession. The Holy Prophet says, yes, no matter how mortal your sin it was, but now that you regretted it, hopefully you receive my intercession. Like the story of, again, remember the reference, the story of the brothers of Yusuf. They committed a mortal sin, undoubtedly, for years even, and they maintained it. However, by the grace of God, before they died, they regretted it, and the intercession was given to them. They received the intercession. First. Second condition is that, please, remember the example of the guy caught in the flood, or the guy who wanted to buy a house. You have to put your utmost efforts in it. What have you done to receive the intercession? Yes, do your very best for the shortfall. The grace of God comes to take your hand. That's why Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, لا تنالوا شفاعتنا من استخف بالصلاة. Those who are careless about their daily prayers. Don't care less about the prayers. They should not expect the intercession. Yes, you prayed, you fast, you endeavor to do whatever possible to you. Let me give you an example. We are in the month of Sha'ban. Inshallah, you have read, and a couple of more coming days and nights, you will be reading that beautiful supplication of Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam, known as Salawat Sha'baniyyah. See how Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam is educating us that the Holy Prophet's lifestyle throughout his life was this, that he was fasting the months of Sha'ban, not as an obligation, as a recommendation. Nights of the months of Sha'ban he was spending in worshiping God. And not only 1 year, 2 years, because some people only they approach God when they are in need. Their needs are met or not met, they turn away immediately. Someone was telling me today that, Sheikh, I did Ziyarat Ashura for 40 days and God didn't give me what I wanted, I stopped it. So, what kind of relation is this with God? Yeah. No, constantly, Imam Zain al-Abidin says, the Holy Prophet, إِلَى مَحَلِّ حِمَامِهِ, all the way to the end of his life, that was his lifestyle and practice. Now you say, Ya Allah, because I want to bring my lifestyle similar, close. Of course, we cannot be like the Holy Prophet, not close to, but at least along with. I try to fast in the month of Sha'ban, couple of days, as many as possible. I try to stay awake in the nights of the month of Sha'ban as much as possible, supplicating, invocating, communicating with my Lord. Then, for the shortfall, the Holy Prophet hopefully will intercede. So do you see? Imam Sadiq alayhi salam wrote a letter. Imam wrote a letter to a group of his followers, and he said in that letter that, do you wish to receive the intercession from those who can intercede? Make sure فَلْيَطْلُبْ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَنْ يَرْضَىٰ عَنْ. Those who wish to benefit from the intercession of the intercessors, they should endeavor to live a life that God is pleased with them. Even if in the past I'm not proud of my past, but now I try to make a change. Another criteria, you keep the count, another criteria is that the intercessor must be a delegate of God, must meet the criteria that I mentioned already. Not every time they can hurry can intercede. Another condition is that from my end, the receiver of the intercession, I should do tawassul. That's what I say, that those who don't resort to God through legitimate means, they should not expect any help. Like the guy who was caught in the flood, unless he raises, he stretches and his arm, raises his hand to grab the rope, he should not expect to be rescued, all right? Unless you come up with some funds, don't expect someone to just buy you a house like this and gift it to you. Doesn't usually happen like this. Okay, so believing in tawassul is part of receiving the shafa'a. Allahu Akbar. The Holy Prophet therefore says, "Man lam yu'min bi shafa'ati, la anala Allahu shafa'ati." Those who don't believe in my intercession, the Almighty God does not give them my intercession. And that's why you see we are reading tonight dua tawassul inshallah soon. It's dua tawassul, but in that dua tawassul, we say, "Ya wajihan inda Allah, ishfa' lana inda Allah." Oh, you, the one who has the honor, has face with God, intermediate or mediate or intercede for me with Allah. Okay? And above all of them, and at the top, at the end also, is that the Almighty God must endorse it through the law that He has made it. No one can, God forbid, bypass the law of God. Perhaps the last, my time is already past the limit, very briefly. The scope of intercession, where is the intercession taking place? Is it on, in this world, in the next? Both of them. Although to meet the condition, I should meet the conditions in this world. Examples of intercession in this world is that when I'm in need and someone will come to help me. For forgiveness of my sins in this world. For meeting my needs in this world. To have the blessing. Ramadan is approaching fast, brothers and sisters. In these remaining days and nights, pray to God to bless us, especially in this critical time of combating COVID-19, so that you are able, physically fit, to be able to meet your obligation of fasting. So, to get the blessing of worshipping God, you need tawassul, and you need the intercession from the other side. In the hereafter, the main place of intercession is on the great day of judgment. And the Holy Prophet's status will be known at that time only. وَلَسَوْفَ يَعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَىٰ. The Imams, they say that this ayah is about that moment, that the Almighty God gives, grants the Holy Prophet the right of intercession so much until the Prophet is pleased. Maqam Mahmud, that is given to the Holy Prophet, the praise status is for that position. At the same time, intercession in the hereafter, it means some who've been hellbound, but they have done the terms, intercession will bring them out, reduces their punishment. Even for those who are in paradise, pay attention to the last and not the least. That is the benefit of meeting the mustahabbat. You are in paradise by the grace of God, eternally living in paradise, but in order for your status in paradise to be elevated, again, you need the intercession. When, remember, for those of you who have been visiting Fatima Masume in Qom, in her ziyarat, we say, Ya Fatima, Ishfa'i li fil Jannah, O Fatima, intercede me in paradise, meaning that by the grace of God, I met the obligations and I received the intercession of the Prophet and now I'm admitted into paradise, but still I want my status in paradise to be elevated. Recommended acts and mustahabbat would elevate them. One of them is ziyarat of Ma'sumin and even the children of Ma'sumin, such as Fatima Ma'sumah Salamullah Alayha. With this, inshallah, allow me to conclude reading last part of Dua Tawassul, inshallah. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد يا وسي الحسن والخلف الحجان أيها القائم المنتظر المهدي يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيها عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله صلوات